What is happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I got my hands on the public beta of Vray 3.4 for Sketchup, and I'm so excited to show you guys some new and amazing features. Let's get started. The first thing you see is the updated user interface. These are the new sets of tools. Most of them are the essential tools from the previous version. What I'm going to focus on today is the new tools and features. Let's break it down. The first one is the asset editor. This is pretty much the combination of both the materials editor and the options editor from Vray 2.0. But it also includes two new things that we never had. They are the lightless and the geometry list. These two lists make it so much easier to manage Vray lights and Vray geometries in your model. Number two is the batch render button. Batch render is useful when you have to render out multiple scenes in your model. For example, in one scene, I may have all of the objects visible, but on the other scene, I want to hide some of those objects. Now with the click of one button, I can easily render both of those scenes. Number three, 6x1 stereoscopic render. This will render a 6x1 ratio cube map that's designed for VR headsets. I currently do not have one, so I cannot give you more information on this, but stay tuned because I will definitely do it later. Number 4, mesh light. This button allows you to turn an object into a light source. Just select a group or component and click this button and bam, there you go. Number 5, light intensity. This button will let you adjust the intensity of any light in your viewport by simply selecting it and dragging up or down. Number 6, this is one of my favorite tools that I've been waiting for, Vray Fur. This feature lets you create fur out of any groups or components. Just select a group and click this button. Now, wait for the magic. Boom.
He's so fluffy, I'm gonna die!
Number 7, Mesh Clipper. This button will let you turn any groups into a special object that will clip away parts of the scene when it's rendered, so now you can easily create 3D sections. And that's it! I know it's a short video, but there's so much I have to learn before I can create in-depth tutorials for all these tools. But I'm so glad I got my hands on the beta today. I'll leave some links in the description box below with more info on the 3.4 version, and you can try to get a beta version yourself. These new tools create so many possibilities of using Vray and Sketchup. I mean, for real though, use the light mesh to turn your teddy bear into a teddy lamp, or create some grass using Vray Fur. Well, that's all I have for today. Smash that like button if you are just excited as I am about the new version of Vray. Don't forget to subscribe, and as always, I'll see you guys next time.